follow my step-by-step instructions, and by the end of this video, you'll be able to make your own animated YouTube intro using your own brand photos like this.
Go there to be by myself, only me. No one can guess what I can.
Or your own video snippet like this. YouTube is becoming more and more competitive, so it's really important that you hook your audience's attention immediately, and a professional-looking intro will help you do that. You don't need to use any awful-looking stock media. All you need is Canva. So let's make a start. Start off by selecting the correctly sized blank template. So you'll need a presentation size template for YouTube, which is 1920 pixels by 1080. So click on the thumbnail to open up a blank template. Next, and this is really important, you want to resize that template by going up to the top left-hand corner of your Canva toolbar and selecting resize. And you want to resize it into a video template, which is this one right here. It has exactly the same dimensions, but we want to use a video presentation template. So to do that, I'm going to place a little tick in this box here and then click on resize. And now that's done, I can see that I have a video editor timeline at the bottom. Right, the first intro we're going to create is with static images. So if you haven't done so already, go to the sidebar on the left-hand side of your screen and go up to Uploads. Click the purple Uploads file button and upload 2 to 3 brand photos from your own device. Once done, drag and drop the first photo onto your template. The photo should snap itself to the background. But if it doesn't do so, just right-click your cursor and then go down and select Set Image as Background. And I do apologise for the quality of these photos. They're not very good and I'm sure you will find better ones. But I'm just using a series of selfie pictures that I take for the purposes of my YouTube videos. Next, you want to add 1 or 2 more pages to the video editor by clicking on this little plus icon to add a page. I'm going to add one more. And then I'm going to drag and drop the other photos onto my template. Sorry about that photo. Right. The reason why I'm only using 2 or 3 pages in this template is because you don't want your YouTube intro to be more than 6 to 8 seconds in duration. Otherwise, you risk losing your audience right at the start of your video, and that's going to really hurt your channel. Next step, we're going to add a little text overlay. Don't add too much text on each page because it will only be viewed for between 3 and 4 seconds. So you might want to start with your channel name or your own name. You might want to make some quick adjustments to the background photo to ensure that the text really does pop. So I'm going to select the background photo, go to Edit Image, and adjust the brightness. So that makes the white text stand out a bit more. And I'm also going to blur the background a little bit, just so that it doesn't grab too much attention. So the emphasis now is on the text rather than the photo. Fabulous. The whole point of using Canva to create your YouTube intro is so that you can customize it so it's completely on brand. So ensure that you've got your own brand fonts set up in your brand kit before you get started. So if I select my text and then look across to the left-hand side column, I'm in my own Nikki Pasquier brand kit, and I've got my heading font set up, my subheading, and my body text set up. And here's a pro tip for you. If you have multiple brand kits set up and you realise you're in the wrong one, don't worry, because if you click on this little downward arrow next to a brand kit name, you can then select the correct brand kit. As well as text, I'm sure you know you can also add some graphics to your YouTube intro. I'm going to click onto the next page. I'm going to repeat this process once again. And I'm also going to include a little graphic. So here you might want to include your business logo. If you've got a brand kit set up, all you need to do is find it by going to the left-hand side toolbar, scroll right down until you find the logo tab, which is usually right at the bottom. Click on that tab and then select your logo to add it to the page. I'm just going to repeat that process again for the final slide. Okay, that's it. Instantly a brand kit is a Canva Pro feature, so if you'd like to take advantage of an exclusive 45-day free trial rather than the standard 30 days, just click the link, which I will leave in the description box underneath this video. So now I have my basic video intro set up, and I'm going to start transforming it by including some very professional edits. Since I've got a series of static images here, I'm going to add a little movement by animating the text and any graphics that are included. So starting on page one, to animate text, as I'm sure you know, I'm going to click on the text to select it, go up to the Animate tab in the toolbar, click on it, and here I have an entire menu of fantastic Canva animations. If you're not familiar with them and you don't know what they look like, just hover your cursor over each thumbnail to see what effect it has on the text on your template. All the animations are free, but as you'll find out in a second, you can customize an animation further with some pro edits. So I'm going to animate my text by selecting the typewriter animation. I can have the animation start as the page appears, so on enter, as the page exits, or both. I'm going to select on enter. I can also customize the speed at which the animation runs by grabbing a hold of this little button with my cursor and sliding it along the slider bar. On that, we'll adjust the speed of the animation. And this is a pro edit. And I can also apply the animation to each separate letter or character or to each word. And that is also a pro feature. I'm going to select character. And that's it. And I'm going to go through that process for the rest of my slides. I can also animate any graphics that I've got. Now, I mentioned a few moments ago that you don't want your YouTube intro to run for more than 6 to 8 seconds. And at the current time, if I look in the top right-hand corner of my Canva toolbar, I can see that it's running at 15 seconds at the minute, because each page will remain on screen for 5 seconds each. So I'm going to edit the timing of each page by clicking my mouse in this box here and then typing 2.5 seconds. I also want that to apply to all of my three pages, so I'm going to toggle this little button to the on position. Fabulous. Now, if I look again in the top right hand corner of my screen, I will see now that my intro now lasts for 7.5 seconds, and I think that's about right. We're almost done now, but before we download this completed video file, there's a second way that I can add a little bit more interest and movement to my YouTube intro, and that is by adding some transitions between each page as they change. So before I do that, I'm going to increase the size of these thumbnail images so that they're easier to work with. So to add transitions between the pages, all I need to do is either hover my mouse in between two pages and then click on this little icon here to add a transition, or I can hover my mouse over the top right hand corner of a page until I see these three little dots, click on the three little dots and select add transition. And on the left hand side of my screen, I now have a menu of beautiful Canva transitions. Again, if you don't know what the transitions look like, just hover your cursor over a thumbnail and see what effect it has on the page. One of my favorite transitions is the color wipe transition, so I'm going to click on it to select it. Underneath, I can now set the duration of the animation. It's currently set at 1 second, but I think I'm going to reduce that to 0.5. I have the option now to change the direction that the transition appears. I really like this one here, so I'm going to click on that to select it. I can also make sure that my transition is totally on brand by changing the colours. So if I click on one of the colour swatches, I have my brand colours underneath, so I can select one of those. In fact, I can do that for the rest of the colours. So let's have a look at that. Fabulous. Now I want to set that transition to appear between all of my pages. So looking down at the bottom of this column, there's a button that says apply between all pages. So I'm going to click on that. And that is done. So you only have to repeat this process once. We are almost finished now, but before we download the completed video file, there's just one more thing I'm going to show you, which is really going to make your YouTube intro look as if it's been created by a professional. I'm going to customize the text and graphics on each slide so that they appear in sequence rather than all at once. If you're not familiar with setting up a sequence of animated elements in Canva, please do watch this video before you attempt this, because otherwise it might be a little bit confusing. You'll find the link to the tutorial in the description box underneath. To set up a sequence of animated elements in Canva, what you're going to do is hold your cursor down and, still holding the cursor down, sweep it over the elements that you want to create the sequence with. So I'm going to sweep it over the text and my logo. Now let go of your cursor and you'll see that the elements are now surrounded by a purple line. Now you are going to right click your cursor, or on a Mac you're going to press Control and right click to bring up a short menu of editing options. Now find Show Timing and click on it. I'm just going to increase the size of the thumbnails a little bit more just to make it easier. And if you look on the video editing timeline, you have now got a purple element timeline. And this is precisely why you want to use a video presentation template, because you can only set up these timings in a video file. Hover your mouse over the purple element timeline and click on this little upward arrow. You can now see a separate purple bar for each element on your page. Each purple bar corresponds with a different element on your page. So if I click on this top bar, that corresponds with my logo. And obviously if I select this one, that corresponds with my text. Now adjust the timings for each element so they appear one by one in sequence on your page. Repeat this process for the remaining pages until you're completely finished. Now let's have a look at our completed YouTube video intro. Of course, you don't have to use photographs to create a YouTube intro. You can of course use a snippet of your own video. So upload the video in exactly the same way as you did do your photographs. You'll find the uploaded video under the videos tab. Just drag and drop the video into your template. Make sure you set it as your background and add text overlay, animations and transitions in exactly the same way as you did with your photographs. If you're unsure about how to add text and images to a video in Canva, you'll find a link to this video tutorial in the description box underneath, so please do check it out. Now that you've got a beautiful branded YouTube intro in place, have a look at this video coming up next, which will show you how to add chapters to each YouTube videos in two different ways. In the meantime, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.